heavy accidents.
Tusenvis av mennesker kommer sjøveien på flukt fra krig, men det greske sjøredningsselskapet har svært lite ressurser og midler for å drive sjøredning. Derfor inviterte redningsselskapet 13 frivillige redningsmenn fra den greske søsterorganisasjonen Hellenic Rescue Team for å lære bort effektiv og god sjøredning. Denne uken har det blant annet vært fokus på hypotermi, krisehåndtering, førstehjelp, opplukk av personer i vannet og søk og redning av folk i dagslys og i mørket.
My name is Nikolaos Priporas. I'm the vice president of Hellenic Rescue Team, and I'm from headquarters of the team from Thessaloniki. I think the teachers are fantastic, very 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 professional, and even we have problem with the language because the English is not even our language or the teacher's language. They are very good to transfer all that knowledge to us. It was fantastic.
De frivillige fra Hellenic Rescue Team fikk kjenne på hvordan det er å ferdes på vannet i enkle gummibåter, og det å måtte klatre ombord igjen etter å ha falt ut.
Jeg er Panagiotis Kostantaras, jeg er volunteer fra Hellenic Rescue Team, branch of Lesbos, who come here 13 persons to have education from RS, to be better rescuers in our country. The situation is very hard, every day become harder because winter coming. We have a lot of wrecks and capsized boats. We have a good cooperation with the Hellenic Coast Guard. They call us anytime when he needs help. We are the team that we dive and pick up the dead persons from the boats, and the most of the times find babies and women inside the boats. So we try to be careful to pick him up with a normal way, and after we go to the land and give them to the port authorities of Lesbos.
August and September, it's crazy month for us. We have 2 and 3 operations per day in the mountain and also in the sea. The last serious operations is the first of November. We have a shipwreck with 11 dead people from Syria. 6 of them are babies, and 5 of them are a woman, maybe his mother of the babies.
Hold on the plastic part, okay, and it says remove the cap. Remove the cap. And we just pull this string. She's nervous. Everyone ready? The fibrillator ready? Yes? Okay, so we just pull this. It is a bright white color, and the emergency one is red. This will also burn. In the water.
The summertime we had a lot of refugees that were staying on the island because they couldn't leave from the island. Nowadays they live with the ship every day, but they are coming more than they're leaving. So we have a lot of refugees in the island, a lot of people with families, with children, women, they don't have to stay somewhere. A lot of people stay in tents. Of course, we have also some shipwrecks. We had a shipwreck 2 days ago. We had 9 dead people. Between them, there were also some children, some women. We try to help, but it's very difficult because we don't know when they are coming and what the situation they are. So if we have a call from the Coast Guard, we operate with the Coast Guard.
Ice is for intravenous infusions.
The situation in Crete is different from the islands which are on the east side of Greece, which are close to Turkey. Basically, you're too far from Turkey or from other countries which have refugees. So we only had a similar incident once, like 6 months ago, where a big boat came from Africa, which 200 refugees. So that happened a few months before the current wave started from Syria. So our situation is different, but we did face it before it got in the news and you know, became a big matter.
You have to communicate between the boats, and you have to coordinate the search. So you do this in an efficient way, like we did in the simulator.
Det er jo personer med mye forskjellig bakgrunn. Noen har både utdanning og praktisk erfaring fra redningstjenesten fra før. Og andre har mindre bakgrunn og mindre erfaring. Så vi har prøvd å legge nivået på et helt grunnleggende nivå for å få de opp på et nivå og gi de både ferdigheter og kunnskaper til å kunne takle situasjonen de er i til daglig på en mye bedre måte.
The hospitality, the training, all the subjects and topics we covered for the training were fantastic. It was a wonderful experience. It is a wonderful experience.